Hello and welcome to.
What? So
just a little wave in the background. Hello and welcome to the Ladies of Lore Dragon Souls campaign.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
What is this, episode 4 or 3? Counting is hard.
I think 3, isn't it?
I feel like 3 is correct, but I'm not sure.
I think it's episode 4.
Is it? Now we're level 4.
Yeah, so third
so
one.
So 3.
Okay. I have been outvoted.
What were you voting on?
4. Because we had the episode where we learned what was happening. The first episode where we went to the Haven of the Goblin King. Last episode where we had the dungeon crawl, making this episode 4.
Yeah, this might actually be episode 4.
Yeah, you're
4.
Right. Yep.
Heyo!
Bad points for Miriam.
Yay!
Counting is hard.
Counting is very hard.
I think we've all had long days.
It's been a long day.
Counting is dumb. Counting is so dumb.
Overrated.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly. Just clearly overrated.
And I totally blocked my face.
Hmm?
I moved far enough up. You cannot see my face. Oh, I can see my face again.
Well, you're the one who's moving away.
I'm just doing that because I need to get something. I'll move back in about 4 seconds.
There. Now the mic is entirely out of shot again. So, hello and welcome to the 4th, then, Ladies of Lore D&D campaign. Wait, hang on, that text says Overwatch. Oops. Aha, now it's fixed. Yes, Gothic, counting is very hard.
Kind of like typing's hard, Gothic.
Mm-hmm.
Well. With that, who remembers what actually happened last episode?
We had to go deal with the bugbears, if I remember correctly.
Yes, we did.
And we went to their labyrinth. And ended up hardcore dungeon crawling.
I feel like labyrinth
might
be a strong
word. Bugbears.
A lot of lumps of meat.
There actually were not that many things that you identified as bugbears. In fact, you all didn't kill a single bugbear.
Nope.
No, the Night Hag took the Bugbear King.
Chief.
And killed the goblins. Yeah.
Okay, the person in charge of the Bugbear.
Yeah.
And then there was a, what was it called?
Barghast. That ate 2 of them, yes, whole.
And we tried to kill, but it ran.
Yeah.
Yeah. Although, if I remember correctly, you were like, oh, I didn't expect you guys to actually do damage to it. Without dying.
We did good.
You all got very lucky with your hits, and I forgot that Haley's whole psionic focus thing meant that she always does damage. Like, magical damage.
Yep. So, I kind of screwed that one pretty good, but...
Just a little bit. But yes, you also killed an ass ton of devils.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you all got some kind of magic items out of it, too. I just don't recall what you all got.
Something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, there were some healing potions.
But he died.
There were some healing potions, but I think you all used most of the healing potions.
I think we got 2 of them and we used both of them.
But you all got actual items as well. Does
anyone
remember what any of them were?
I got the Wand of Secret and the Dust of Dryness.
Oh, right, yeah. And then Haley
the
got something.
Kind of... The sneaky, sneaky, and the kind of useless.
Did I not write it down?
I remember what yours was, but I don't know what else you got. There was a 4th one. Yeah, there was the alchemy jug.
Oh, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
But there was a 4th one. Yeah, wasn't there? There was a 4th item.
Was it the crossbow bolts?
Yes, it was...
+1 crossbow?
Yeah,
I got those ones.
+1 crossbow bolts, that was it.
Yeah.
I knew it was something minorly offensive.
Yeah, because I had really good, finding things.
Mm-hmm.
Remarkably good, so I got 2 things and then everyone else got 1.
Okay. So yes, with that, you all returned to the inn because you all felt disgusting and wanted baths. You very briefly met with the...
Why did gonna do this again.
Sorry,
it keeps demoting my armor class to 11, and my armor class is not 11.
No, you were like at kicking butt 17 or something.
Yeah. And you all very briefly met the Yonti that was sent to, like, join you.
Didn't he, like, take a look at us, and he basically took one look at us and was like, you guys probably want to take a bath or something, or just...
He didn't say...
They didn't say anything. Not in as many words, but, like...
They literally didn't say anything. They looked you up and down and just sort of backed out of your way.
Yep.
Yeah.
Back into whatever room that they had come from, because it looked like you had been spread out into two rooms now.
Yeah.
So yes, you all were going to take a bath. Marvel was going to leave you all to it. I think we can safely assume that you all have successfully taken a bath.
Yes.
Do you have plans after that? Because it's not super late.
Food?
Okay.
I mean, I'm kind of curious what the Yonti has to say, but... I mean... maybe drinking is part of the agenda, since we're in the tavern.
Can invite him downstairs to the bar.
Yeah, like get cozy in the bar.
Yeah.
And stuff. Oh no.
Because he might feel more comfortable there, rather than in a corridor.
Do any of you have money?
Yes.
A bit.
Drop.
15.
Oh, where'd it go?
I think we got money from, like, one of the...
Oh, you all got gems worth money.
Yes, I
have. Yeah, yeah. Maybe, depending... I'm trying to decide, like, should we sell the gems?
I mean, if you would like them to be worth any amount of money, yes.
I mean, I want to sell my gem.
Yeah, because there's not much we can... You can't eat a gem.
Well,
or, I mean, you could... But I don't think it goes so well going down and coming out.
Probably not.
Definitely
you
not.
Mostly just wanted to get your second sword, though.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna sell and buy.
Yeah, because you all really quickly, you all hit fourth level, so that means you got to pick feats or ability scores. Did anyone pick any... Well, what did you all take?
I took dual wielding. So I can become an even more fearsome murder machine.
I totally spaced on that.
Just stab all the things twice.
Okay. How many of these do we get?
All the stabby.
You can either get two ability score upgrades. So you put a plus one on one ability on either two different abilities, or put a plus two on one ability, or you can get one feat.
I'm just gonna upgrade my wisdom real quick. I'm going to go for 13 wisdom. That could be much more useful.
What were you at already?
11.
You know that there's only a benefit for getting the 12, right?
Oh, well then. Let's go make this 12. And... let's make me a little more charismatic.
So we're making you...
Being around these very charismatic people, I'm learning how to take my foot out of my mouth.
Slightly.
Only slightly.
Stephanie, sorry, what did you say?
Tiny bit.
Oh, I forgot about the feats, too, so I just took a 2 in my charisma.
Okay. Doesn't that put your charisma up to something psychotically high?
19.
Okay. So you're one away from the max. Got it.
Yeah.
If that didn't make noise.
What?
Sorry, someone sent me a message on an entirely different thing.
Oh.
So yeah, I guess you all would like to sell your gems then to actually have slightly more than $0?
I mean, we don't have zero. We're just really broke.
Yeah, we're a little broke.
Okay. Well...
Then... I'm going to go find a shop to sell it in.
Okay, give me a d20.
Okay, hang on. Out of my way character sheet, I don't need you right now. 14.
With that, you find, like, a pretty decent looking, hobgoblin shop.
Mm-hmm.
It just sort of looks like a sort of a general store.
Sounds
if
good.
Such a thing could exist among hobgoblins.
I mean, they did a really good job with the inn while we were sleeping.
See, there's a difference between an inn where people have to sleep and selling stuff.
That's fair.
Yeah. Like, it's on the outer edges of the city, so mm-hmm. it's more like a trading area, but still, it's not a thing that hobgoblins do as much as everyone else.
Okay.
So, its supplies are a touch limited.
Is there someone standing at any sort of a counter type thing, or who looks like they own the shop or are in charge of the trading in the shop?
I mean, there's a person at a counter with what you would call a cash register, basically.
That works, too.
By cash register, I basically mean it is literally a box with a lock on it that you're pretty sure he puts money into.
That works. Oh, that's pretty funny. And you should check out the chat.
I've seen it.
Steph, are you in the chat for Twitch?
I am not.
Okay, so, Squee.
Hi!
Oh, hey, Squee is here. I didn't even see that was Squee. Sorry.
Yeah, that was
Gothic
Squee.
And Squee have the same color in my chat for some reason.
So, Squee commented in, and he's like, Hobmart is a fine and upstanding establishment.
Yes, okay, I'm going to say right now, just, this place is now called Hobmart. Got it.
Thanks, Squee.
Okay, coin the term.
I like it.
Yes,
you is sneaky.
Okay. Hello, my good gentlemen. I would like to trade with you today.
Welcome to Hobmart. What can I get for you?
This is all your fault, Squee.
Okay, I feel like this should be a t-shirt. Hobmart, a fine and upstanding establishment. I have a thing to sell. Do you perhaps buy from adventurers?
What the hell is an adventurer? What do you have to sell?
I have a thing. I have a gem to sell you.
Can I see it?
Sure. I reach into my bag and I pull it out. It is shiny.
He sort of looks it up and down, pulls out a little, magnifying glass from behind the counter. I'll give you 8 gold.
Can I roll charisma to try to bark, to try to, like, haggle with him?
Hang on, let me look at a character sheet real quick.
Because the goal, it's supposed to be worth 10 gold.
Yes, it is worth 10 gold. That doesn't mean you're ever going to get 10 gold for it. Give me a persuasion roll with disadvantage.
I wish you were on this screen instead of that screen.
I'm sorry, but it would take a ton of time to actually reset it.
I know.
Disadvantage. Oh, right.
Yeah.
He sort of looks at you, quite frankly, annoyed now. Just, no! I have to turn a profit here. Get out of my store. I run an upstanding business.
I take my gem back from him and put it in my bag. Fine, I shall take my business elsewhere. And I walk out of the shop.
Okay.
That went poorly.
So I'm not following her. I'm gonna go to my own place.
Okay.
Great.
You find a slightly less reputable shop. There's totally a hobgoblin behind the counter, but basically every surface has just these massive cages on it that are nailed to the floor. And as you come in, it becomes immediately clear why, because you're a little bit closer to, like, a goblin area of town. So everything that isn't nailed down, they're, like, grabbing the cages and shaking them, trying to knock things out and run away with them.
Oh, no.
And the hobgoblin behind the counter just looks really tired of this. And he actually brightens up a little bit upon seeing not a goblin walk through his door.
Right. So I'll walk up, ask if he has, basically pull out the gem and ask if he's interested in buying, and I am also interested in, selling a few weapons.
Sorry, no, I need the people to not see the chat anymore now, because apparently I'm just going to take all of Squee's names.
Seriously?
Yeah.
They're so good.
You're so good at this, Squee. Too good.
These are pretty funny.
Like I said, as soon as he saw you, his eyes, like, sparked up. He's like, here at Poblet Express, we take anything!
Okay. What will you give me for this?
Well, that depends. Are you looking for a trade or just for some quick cash?
Well, I have a few trades, but I also need to buy something.
Well, what are you looking to buy?
A longsword.
Just one?
Just one.
Thank you, Squee, for following. Sorry that you got a Zarya emote. I know you do not play Zarya. Like, well, I mean, we might be able to upgrade you to something better than a longsword.
And what would you have?
Well, I might have some magic items in the bag.
I might be interested in seeing these might be magic items.
Well, how interested? What would you be looking to trade me, maybe?
I have a spear and a short sword. And my gem.
I thought you had a crossbow, too.
I do. I don't know when I'm going to need ranged weaponry.
I thought you had the bad crossbow.
No, I sold that one already.
Oh, okay. I mean, this could be a really nice magic sword, and we do have a pretty good layaway program. But for you... And because I'm pretty sure you used that spear to kill somebody I know, I'll do a trade for all of that for... And then he sort of, like, reaches back behind him and pulls out a, like, immaculately made longsword with, like, a price tag that... Because you can read Goblin, and many goblins actually can't read Goblin... You can tell is literally just a bunch of random squiggles, but goes on for, like, a very long time. Like, it's literally just a bunch of random letters.
Mm-hmm.
I can offer you this for all of that.
Can I do a perception check to see how the sword's made, quality, and stuff?
Yes. I would say... So give me a perception check, and then also give me an arcana check. It should all be alphabetical.
Yeah, but I'm at my brain capacity of like 25% right now.
I know.
I'm stating for everyone else, though.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so with that perception check, you're definitely able to tell that this is actually a pretty well-made sword. It seems a little bit weird. You don't know a ton about metallurgy, but it seems different from a lot of swords that you've seen regularly. And with the arcana, you can tell that there is definitely something magical about it, but without closer inspection, you doubt that you could figure it out easily.
Okay, I'll go ahead and make the trade.
Okay.
And I'm picking it up and I'm looking at it and... You know, a him and haw for a second, and I'm like, this will be a fine trade.
Okay. He very happily shakes your hand, sets the sword down on the counter, and then picks up all of the things that you've got and hastily scribbles more price tags that make absolutely no sense, and sets them down very quickly, like, runs around the counter, opens up a cage, and puts it inside the cage and relocks it before goblins can grab at the things. And as you're watching, you can tell that it's pretty clear that the goblins are assuming price based entirely on length of the price tag on it.
Okay. Got it.
Because they'll grab one and go, it's really long. I don't think I can afford this. This one's really short. Here, can I have this?
Got it. And I will proceed to walk out of said establishment, pick my sword up, sheath it, and
okay.
Get out my merry little way.
Sweet.
And then, Moira, are you still attempting to find a new shop?
Yeah. Because Moira sucks.
Yes. Well, give me a roll with disadvantage.
A d20?
Yeah.
Okay,
so just roll 2d20. Slash roll 2d20.
Okay.
And I'm going to take the lower one. You can actually just copy this stuff from the longsword one-handed.
Oof. Neither of those are pretty good.
No, but I'm taking the 4.
Ah, damn it. I might just, walk in and turn around and walk right out again.
You walked into another Poblin Express 24 hours checks, checks and cash accepted.
Is it even worse?
It is significantly more run down. In fact, there are no windows. There's just sort of, really hasty. They're not even leather. It's just hides hung over where windows probably should be. With a really, really short hobgoblin sitting at a back table, sort of, cowering from his own customers. Because
okay.
He does not have cages to keep his items in, so they're just running around screaming, swinging sticks with price tags around. On the upside, when you can catch a glimpse, these price tags actually do say numbers on them.
Sweet. I'm gonna see how this goes. I'm gonna... What? You know what? Why not? This is part of the fun. Okay. I walk up to the counter. Hi!
What? Hi! You look sane! What can I do for you?
I would like to trade an item for... I would like to sell you an item.
What is it?
I pull out a gem, and I pull out my gem, and I hold it up in front of him. But I do not hand it for him. Hand it to him.
I don't think I can accept that.
Oh. Okay, then. I put it back, and I walk out the door.
He looks really pleading as you leave. Just like, no, please save me.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna walk out. I had the slightest thought of, do I stay and help police the store? Or do I have other things to do today? And do I really want to get into a fight with a bunch of scrappy little goblins?
I mean, they're goblins. They have 7 health.
I know. I go back to the inn, walking fairly sadly and disconsolately.
Okay.
Back to the inn. Because I didn't sell my gem.
Fine! Are you doing anything prosperous right now?
It was just those two that got the gems, right?
No, everyone got a gem. There were 3 of them.
Okay, gonna go and search for a magic shop, then.
A magic shop? Sure.
Yeah. So, perception, yeah?
I would say give me you're actually a magic user, so yeah, give me a perception check with advantage. I don't think that was
try
with
that
advantage.
Again. No.
Well, you just have to do better than 3. That's much better than 3.
Yeah, just a little.
So you start turning down towards the Cell Central Poblin Express and then immediately go, there's no magic over here, and about face. And you actually head almost to the very center of the city and find a... Basically, it looks like you've sort of walked into, almost a college campus. Just a very, very small one. And attached to said campus is a tiny little magic shop over in one corner.
Nice. I will walk into said shop.
Inside is a tall, remarkably skinny hobgoblin, you actually haven't seen any that aren't super muscly, who's just sort of patiently waiting at the counter and looks kind of surprised to see not a hobgoblin.
Right. Walk up to the counter. Hello, can I sell this? Hand him the gem.
He looks at it and goes, I'll offer you 9 gold for it.
Got yourself a deal.
Passes you 9 gold and looks quizzically. I can tell that you're a practicer of the art. Can I offer you anything?
What do you have?
Well, that depends entirely on what you need. I may not have it now, but this is the Devastator College right next to us. They could probably make it.
Shucks. I actually didn't have anything in particular in mind.
You're just like, I want a magic shop.
Yes.
Well, given the time and preparation, they could create scrolls for you. Probably some very minor magic items. Admittedly, they won't have any significant skill with anything that doesn't explode, but better than nothing. You have no idea, do you?
No, I'm sorry.
Okay. It's just sort of...
You're just going to give me a couple things to choose from.
Oh, no. Like, this is very much a shop for the discerning taste. This is what you get for a 21.
I'll come back. No pre-made stock.
They have pre-made stock, but it's just like health potions and some simple stuff like that.
How much are your health potions?
They are... I need to actually check. Oh, 75 gold each.
Okay, no.
Well, when...
Yeah,
when you are more prepared to spend some money, we'll be here for you.
Thanks for taking the gym. All right. And I'll go back to the inn.
Okay. The three of you meet back up at the inn, some of you with more money, some of you without.
Some of you with the same amount of money you left with.
One of you with a magic sword. In heavy air quotes.
Urf. I didn't know if you wanted that.
Not immediately, but I can definitely use it. No, this is significantly more of a legitimate store than Weasley's Wizarding Wheezes. This is the best way to think of that shop that you found is basically that it is the Devastator College is where they teach hobgoblins to use magic, and they basically sell anything that they make that is worthy of being sold. Yeah.
Nice. That's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm. So as they arrive back, as you arrive back at the inn, the sun is probably starting to go down at this point. It's probably like 6 at night or so. So the sun is starting to go down, but it's definitely not dark yet. Margul is waiting for you at the inn. Just right by the entrance.
Hi.
Is that Margul?
That's new.
Well, I assumed you all would want food and that you still don't have any money.
Yes and yes. How discerning of you, sir.
So he just walks you all back inside the inn and immediately, still not knowing what any of you all eat, just orders a whole bunch of, like, roasts and roasted birds and meat and things.
I mean, they all do the trick.
Yeah.
It works.
And orders several flagons of, like, ale.
Hmm.
At which point, the Yonti also sort of, like, slithers up.
That's weird, because it's like a snake thing.
Yeah. It has, like, a... Its lower body is a snake body, and its head is a snake head.
Ah.
But it's, like, tried to take on as many dragon-ish
features. Yeah, like, it's a snake head, but it has sort of, like, dragon-y ridges across its forehead. And instead of the same, like, flat arrowish head. It started, they've, over a couple of generations, they've started to get more, like, pointed, almost like the dragon-ish beak. But it's okay. Still very clearly a snake. But it's just been trying to not be a snake anymore.
Got it.
Oh, hey, this person.
It quietly nods at you.
You were sent to give us aid?
It nods again.
What? Are you going to communicate solely by nods and head shakes?
It shrugs its shoulders.
Ah. Okay.
Great.
Anybody else want to take a go at this?
Hey, Miss Charismatic.
Can you tell us their name at least?
I actually need to check its name.
It
basically lifts up its head so that its chin is pointing straight up and points to like a massive scar across its throat.
Oh.
And writes down that its name is Jiki.
Jiki. Got it.
Sweet. Oops.
And I have spelled it for you in the chat.
Jiki.
Thank you.
Jiki.
Yeah.
I was going to ask.
Okay, that's a lot of eyes.
Nobody else? Does the rest of the world not know? Get to know how it's spelled?
Nope.
Oh, I mean, yes, I guess the rest of the world can fine. The rest of the world can know how Jiki's name is spelled.
Looking out for you.
They can guess.
Jiki.
There you go. Like, it can still hiss, but beyond that, not really anything else.
Okay.
And, so speech is not a thing.
And even as it's, like, darting its tongue in and out, you can see that even... It's not as, like, tiny as a lizard, as a snake tongue, mm-hmm. So it's a little bit more substantial. You can see that there's even, like, scarring on its tongue.
Wow.
Aww, poor little guy. That's kind of rough.
While Jiki has pen and paper, I ask, what were you sent here to help us with?
It tries to... It sort of looks at the... It's not a pen and paper, it's like a slate.
Yeah.
And it looks at it briefly, trying to figure out the most concise way of explaining.
Can you show us?
And it basically writes down, not dying, and, like, magic and tech.
Oh, okay. Do you want to join us?
It sort of tilts its head at you almost like a puppy, like, am I here? Am I not here?
No, I mean to, like, sit with us. Like, sit down and dine with us.
It again sort of tilts its head and holds up a pouch of money, like, I'm the only one here who has money. And, like, jingles and is visibly more full than any of your purses.
Oh.
Yeah, we're not paying for it. Come and sit, join us.
To which it shrugs and... looks for the first, like, boneless piece of meat it can and basically swallows it whole, because snake.
Oh, okay.
Cool.
Does Marvel know about Jiki?
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't know if we need to make an introduction.
Margle does not know who Jiki is, but was basically sitting next to you all while you just had the same introduction. Okay. But he had heard that you had a fourth... emissary coming.
Yeah. We have a new NPC.
Yup.
Yay.
Can we finish dinner and then he shows us what he has brought, or?
Yeah, I mean, sure.
Yeah.
I mean, he's very much enjoying the slowly eating an entire piece of, like, ham or something. he does notice the, like, weird sword you're carrying and, like, taps you on the shoulder. And tries to, like, charades for, can I look at it?
Oh, this thing? Sure, I guess you can.
And so as you all are eating, and he's basically just swallowed a massive meal and is sitting there digesting it, he's looking at it, and in the strangest way possible, seeing as he has no eyebrows, lifts an eyebrow at it. Where it's just, like, part of his face just sort of lifts up in a weird... reflection.
Oh, it kind of shifts.
Yeah.
Yeah,
like,
in the middle of eating, I look around like, what, Jiki?
And again, he sort of stares at his slate, trying to figure out the shortest way to say it. It's like, it's weird.
Weird how? Like, weird bad or weird good?
It's magic. I don't know what it is.
Would you be able to figure it out if you sat down with it for a little while?
Probably.
Would you mind sitting down with it? I have a different kind of magic.
Sounds like fun.
So I'm gonna let Jiki have my sword and look at it and examine it, because I use psionic and I'm not a magic user.
Yeah, you destroy people's minds, and by extension, their bodies. So, Margul has been sort of, like, watching this exchange, and sits up and informs you all that, now, I know that we had some issues with that whole Barghast thing.
Jeez, what gave it away?
The fact that you turned and booked it?
Because it would have eaten me as well, yes.
We went over this, we get it. So, what did you have to say?
Actually, about the other thing there, the hag.
That took
the
bear chief?
Yeah. So, I went over our records, and we know that wherever we came from before we came to the Nexus, we had hags there. And we think that some of them came over. We have very, very clear records about them, because they had a habit of trying to turn hosts into, well, personal armies.
That sounds terrible.
They're very...
And she's got the bugbear chief?
Well, that's just it. That's not something they would do. They're very powerful fey beings. They don't take people. Usually, they would just wait for the warlord of a host to be desperate enough to come ask for help. And then they would exact some horrible price from him.
Ha!
But this time, they didn't wait. They just exacted a horrible price.
They didn't exact a horrible price. They just took him, which doesn't fit with Faye. So I just don't actually know what's going on.
I mean, it could technically be a horrible price.
Maybe, but only if that the chief had made some sort of deal with them.
Interesting.
The issue that we're actually running into, though, is this was far too bold a plan for a single lone hag.
Oh, good.
I think there might be a coven.
Great.
And
oh,
that this
no.
is one hag trying to get more power over the other two in the coven. But that raises...
A hag guild.
But that raises an issue. Hags usually only form covens with family.
So she's got a sister or two?
Children.
Oh.
And at least according to our records, and I don't know if you all have any records either, the only way they can reproduce is by eating human children. And I've never seen a human on Nexus.
I was about to ask, are there humans in the Nexus?
Yeah.
I've checked our records, and we literally have nothing about having seen a human since we came here.
Okay.
That doesn't sound good.
Jiki sort of looks up at this and also writes down on his slate, on their slate, we also have no records of humans on Nexus.
Oh dear.
So, somehow a hag is reproduced by eating human children.
In a world that doesn't contain humans.
Yeah.
That's comforting.
Well, on the
There's a problem with that.
On the upside, I think I know where they are.
Okay.
Where?
There's a coast... Well, village is probably a strong word, but there's a coastal village about 30 miles northeast of here that we've had some interactions with in the past.
What kind of interactions?
They're bullywogs, so generally telling them to get out of our way and give us food, and them doing it. And we sent out... I had Raven sent out earlier today since we found out about the hag, and what I've discovered is that one of the best ways to find out if someone has a hag problem is ask if they have a hag problem, and if they vehemently deny it, they probably have a hag problem.
Usually, so how do you deal with an infestation of hags?
Generally, kill them.
I mean, uh-huh. We killed everything else up until this point, so what's stopping us?
Everything. If you thought you could make a better deal with them, then that would work, but that's sort of the whole thing with hags and fae in general, is they're probably going to weasel out or somehow get the better end of the deal.
So you want us to go into an extermination run?
I want you to find out why they're taking a bugbear.
That would probably be good.
I don't think you all can handle a coven of hags, to be honest.
I turn to Cheeky. Have you brought anything that might help us with this particular problem?
Cheeky sort of shrugs, opens the satchel at its side, and pulls out a couple of, like, what you're pretty sure are healing potions, and something that you're actually not sure what the hell it is. But looks like a weapon of some sort that they set on the table. And Jiki sort of goes, maybe? Like, smile but shrug.
Can I do a perception on it?
On what?
The thing on the tape that he set on the table.
Okay.
That he set.
I mean, with disadvantage, because you have literally no idea what it is.
I'm just gonna see what I can... what I can figure out about it just by looking at it.
Okay.
Just like if I could use any crafting knowledge to just figure it out.
It's definitely made out of metal. It appears to have a trigger like a crossbow, but beyond that, you're really not sure at all.
Hmm. Okay. I turn towards Jiki. What does this do?
It lifts it to its shoulder, sort of pops open the thing, makes sure that, I guess that you're assuming that it's not loaded, closes it back up and, like, holds it to its shoulder as though it's firing a crossbow.
Oh, cool. Sweet.
So this is more of an intel gather information, kind of thing, rather than extermination.
At least initially. The big concern with a full coven of hags is that one of them may be an auntie or a grandmother. A hag who's powerful enough that they've started to affect the area around them.
Oh dear.
Usually subconsciously.
Okay.
Ha.
And depending on the variety of whichever one is in charge, there are going to be nasty side effects.
Great. That sounds good.
If it's a sea hag in charge, there could be dead fish washing up everywhere. There could be a disgusting coating of slime everywhere. I know that some of our records point to forest hags leaving behind strange illusions that they can see through that are subconsciously linked to them somehow. Whose entire point is largely to scare the living crap out of anything coming nearby. And alert the hag to their presence.
Huh.
Got it.
Cool. That sounds dangerous.
Okay.
Generally so. The bullywogs also aren't for the best, but I think you all can scare them into line relatively quickly.
Hmm. Sounds good.
Is it mostly because bullywogs haven't seen things like us?
No, they're cruel, evil little creatures, but As soon as it becomes clear that you are more powerful than them, they'll tend to back down.
Oh, that makes it easy.
Okay.
So when do we leave?
Well, I'm only asking you to do this. You can leave whenever you choose. I can't go with you.
Why?
Oh, why not on
this?
Because I'm a general, I can't leave my legion behind.
That's right. You're now the... Okay. Jiki, do you want to come with us?
It sort of looks at you confused, like, and writes down, why would you think I wasn't?
I mean, never hurts to ask.
Last time, we were sent on our own, so we thought maybe you were just sent here to A, give us things, or B, give us information, and then you were gonna leave.
Yeah.
And it starts writing down, I was sent here because... It sounded like this was way worse than expected.
That is true, and so we appreciate your help.
Or not way worse, more complicated than expected.
That is
complicated
true.
Describes it quite well.
Yeah.
So, shall we leave in the morning?
Think that would be the best.
Jiki sort of nods as well.
Yep.
Yeah. All right.
Okay. So, Margul sits up, glad that you've all agreed on a plan. I will have wargs ready to ride you out at dawn.
Oh god, more riding?
Unless you want to walk 40 miles.
Nope, no,
riding is good.
I'm good.
Okay. So, I'm going to say that your rest passes largely uneventfully.
What is the other part instead of actually uneventfully?
I mean, there's probably goblins fighting around you, but not...
Oh, that's normal.
Yeah, that's what I was saying, largely uneventfully. I'm sure something happened in the night, but it didn't affect any of you.
Sounds good.
Ugh.
Sounds like a normal night with the goblins.
Actually, let me check something really quick. Miriam, your character doesn't have dark vision, right?
No, I don't, actually.
Before you go to bed, Jiki hands you a set of goggles.
Oh, cool. Thank you.
And motions like, put on. And then I drop the stuff.
Okay. I pull the goggles onto my head so that my crest sticks straight up into the air.
At which point, Jiki, like, puts out all of the torches in the room. Showing that you can see in the dark with these goggles on.
Oh, cool!
Because everyone else has dark vision.
Except me.
Yeah.
Oh, these are awesome, thank you!
Okay, and yes, so that'll probably be the last thing that actually happens in that night.
Sweet. I will add this to my stuff.
Oh, goodness, ow. So, when you wake up in the morning, just right before dawn, there are four wargs sitting, just basically waiting for you all, right in almost tied up like horses, basically, right in front.
Nice, wargy, wargy, wargy. I hold my hand out to it.
Give me that animal handling check.
Oh, no.
Do I have animal handling?
I don't remember.
I don't know if I do.
I don't think this went so
well. Oh my god, I do!
Well, it went poorly last time, so let's see if it goes better
so
this time.
It went so poorly last time. Let's see.
Oh, hey!
Oh! Wow!
This is an entirely different warg who immediately loves you. Like, you forgot to wash your hands last night, and there was still some meat on it when you went to sleep.
I still smell like meat.
And it's just like, oh, nom 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 nom, and chomps down on a bunch of random stuff that was, like, under your claws or something.
Aw, I think I made a new friend, guys, look!
Gross.
That's great.
At least Jiki is looking at you concerned, like, and sort of pulls Nadar aside, just like, does she wash her hands?
You know?
Oh,
normally I think so. I think she might have had a little bit too much ale last night.
That's a possibility.
The snake head, like, in a way that you didn't think was possible, the snake head just sort of, like, frowns and looks concerned.
I know, I'm also concerned right now, Jeehee.
Aw, I'm petting the warg.
Yeah, I imagine that Moira's over there petting the warg, and Jeehee and I are just kind of... My upper lip has been pulled back, and Jeehee's just kind of like... Because you said, oh, look, I made a new friend, and Nadar was like, gross.
Well, now you all get to try and make the animal handling check, so...
I don't want to make me...
Boy.
Oh, that didn't do that as Jeehee. Oops.
I mean, it says it underneath.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This is gonna go badly.
These are all...
It goes the best out of everyone else.
These are all decent, but none of you have, like, the same perfect relationship that Moira has somehow now established with this warg.
That's okay.
No, they just regular wargs.
Yeah, they're largely unconcerned with this, but allow you to get up on their backs. Jeehee is a little bit awkward, because they
snake.
Have to, like, wrap their tail around the warg as loosely as possible. But otherwise, uneventfully, you all just start riding off in the direction that you were instructed by Morgul.
Sweet.
And also, I, like, squeeze comment.
Yeah.
Which thing?
Also, like,
some goblin on the phone at night, trash talking their in-laws.
Yeah. Yep, that would be a disturbance.
Yeah, I mean, you do have to pass through some of the more unsavory neighborhoods on your way out, including the, what did we decide it was called? The
South Central
the South Central location of Poblin Express 24-hour checks cashed, and... There's actually a fire on the top of it now.
Are we talking about the, like, middle of the road one that I
went to? No, this is the bad one.
Or the really shitty one.
This is the really
bad one that I turned around and was just kind of like...
The one without candles.
Okay, bye!
Yeah, there is a fire burning in it now. However, all of the goblins continue to, like... It's a different group of goblins, but they're still there trying to, like...
Loot the store.
They're not even looting the store. They're just picking up items and shouting at the salesman about wanting them.
That looks like a ton of fun.
Like, one of them is literally carrying a stick that is now on fire going, I want this stick! And the salesman is just like, I don't care! Take it!
Like,
guys, let's go there when we're done.
Gotta love Squee. You should look at their comments.
This is being
God damn, I'm unsubscribed from Lur again. Hang on, I have to go fix something so that I can do the everything is fine.
Why are you unsubscribed?
Because I have Twitch Prime, so it makes me resubscribe every time. Hang on. I have to do this. It's important.
It's apparently very, very important.
So yeah, every month I have to resubscribe to Twitch.
It still counts your...
Yeah, because I never go a month without being subbed.
Mm-hmm.
I just... Damn it. The emotes aren't back yet. No! I need to get access to their Everything is Fine emotes. No! But yeah, there is a small fire definitely going on in that store now.
It's a little early. Aw,
man.
Never too early for fire.
It looks like he's having a bad day.
So as you start...
He's having a bad life.
As you all start riding out from the Goblin City, you actually start heading... It starts to look almost like a downright real forest. But the deeper and deeper you get into this forest, it becomes more swampy and more desolate.
Ooh.
To the point that...
Are you just going to keep refreshing that until your emotes are back?
See? Now it works.
Jesus.
Okay.
So, you... Probably 10 miles out from where you actually expect to be, it's become a full-on swamp. And... It's starting to look... not just unnatural, but actively hostile to life. Like,
oh boy,
there aren't any more deer or rabbits or anything simple, anything that you would tend to associate with a calm, relaxed place. There are, but constantly you're seeing, like, massive, like, really massive, poisonous-looking toads. Wolves, not coyotes, vultures in the air, snakes of almost every kind that you've ever heard of. Just so many...
This looks bad.
Yeah. Like, it seems like all of the normal life has just left this area.
Right, real quick, I'm going to cast mage armor on myself. Just,
okay.
Just to get it out of the way.
Okay.
I'm just going to have my crossbow out.
And Jiki has got the strange weapon that you saw that he, or that they showed you, sort of slung over one shoulder.
Okay. Let's party.
All right. Keep on checking.
Again, very shortly after, you finally arrive to the Bullywug village that you were directed towards. And it's basically just a collection of mud huts.
So, like, when we first went into the goblin
city? No. Like, those were... The ground was mostly clean and had been built, and there were sort of, like, foundations set, but it was, like, stone, brick, and animal hides. These are literally mud from the swamp that they are sitting in. Yeah.
Oh, boy. I'm really glad I have the dry powder. That could be useful here.
Can I turn one light off? Which one do you want?
Either. You can turn off both if you need to.
Is it going to screw with the lighting?
No.
Okay,
is there anybody outside?
No, there's actually no one visible at all.
This is... creepy.
Can I do a perception check to see if anything seems, like, off? Like, if there is, like, scuffle or anything around? Or if it's just deserted?
Sure, give me a perception check.
Oh, wow, hello, old map.
Boop.
Yeah, you're all still on the old map. you get the feeling that this place is creepy. And that's pretty much all you got, is just, this place is creepy and wrong and bad. Very,
can
very
I roll perception?
Bad.
Okay.
Yes, you can roll perception.
Okay.
Haley, you can also roll perception.
I was like, I want to roll perception.
Oh, that's good.
Okay. Sneaky Pants, you notice that...
Okay.
This is probably a pretty good place for someone to try and ambush you, because they could be hiding in any of these huts and things. They could be hiding in any number of places in the swamp. This seems a little bit too easy. Nadar, with that one, you're able to tell that there are definitely living things nearby. Like, you can feel them psionically, that there's some sort of living things. Though not what they are, or if they're intelligent living things, or just animals.
Okay.
And there's also a very, very powerful mental presence just sort of washing over this area.
Hmm.
I'm curious if this could be the mental side effect thing. Subconscious side effect thing. Marble was talking.
This could be bad.
But you're all just hiding out on the... Just not even hiding out, just sitting on your wargs, just staring at a bunch of mud huts.
Hmm.
I turn to Jiki and see if he has any... body language about it. Or if he's just also staring.
he sort of, like, tries to... I'm trying to figure out the best way to say it, but, like, he... Or they motion for, like, a shiver. Like, something...
Bad.
Like, things bad.
Like, bad juju.
Yeah, like, bad juju.
Should we go investigate? I don't know. I'm getting a bad feeling from this place.
I am too, but I'm trying to decide, trying to make a decision about something. Can I roll for insight?
What do you mean?
To see if I all of a sudden remember anything about Bollywog tactics.
That would not be insight.
What would that be?
I would say maybe history.
Oh, okay. Yeah, definitely. Can I go ahead and roll for that?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
I mean, you're aware that they're basically relatively weak species and that their entire thing is ambush.
Okay. I relay this to the group. From what I remember, they tend to fight by hiding and then attacking. So, I have a really bad feeling about this place.
What is everyone's passive perception, real quick, by the way?
12.
13.
14.
12, 13, 14... let me check what Jeeky's is before I forget. 12. And then actually do all of them. Okay, almost immediately upon announcing that, y'all notice three sets of eyes in the muck sort of behind you. That just sort of look like frog eyes peering up through the muck.
We see you.
I mean, that's what you're going with? Just, we see you to some frog eyes?
I mean, I've got my short bow in hand still.
Can I use Mage Hand to drag one of them out?
Mage Hand can only exert 10 pounds of force.
Oh, that's right. Darn.
You could poke him in the eye?
Can I?
Like cartoon style?
I don't know if it's a good idea to provoke it.
No, probably not.
Literally.
Jeeky is much less concerned than you all are and just sort of turned, leveled their gun at one of them and just opened fire.
Oh, the thunder monster.
Okay. We're getting this.
And the thing he fired at rather simply just sort of explodes in sort of a wet, mushy pile inside the... what the hell is that? Sorry, there was just horrible noises coming through someone's mic.
I heard the noises.
So, the thing that he fired at just turns into a wet, mushy pile that sort of spreads out through the muck. The other two immediately stand up and, like, hold up their hands. It's like...
Who are you?
They sort of croak quietly and go, Bullywogs?
Where's the rest of your village?
Pretty much all around you? You're in the middle of it.
Oh boy.
I turned to Geeky. And, you know. Are they still holding their gun at fire?
Well, he basically, or they basically, like, popped it open, pulled a little thing out of it, and replaced it, but otherwise they just sort of have it slung over, not even slung, just sort of, like, resting against their shoulder.
Oh boy. So, is there someone we can, like, in charge that we can talk to?
We were going to capture you and bring you to the king.
How about you just escort us there, since, I don't think the capturing thing is gonna go so well.
Okay. And as these two are escorting you through the village, more and more of them just sort of pop up, like, oh, I guess they lost. Okay. And by the end of it, there's almost like 4 dozen of these things that have just popped out of the muck.
Oh my goodness.
And eventually they walk you over to what is effectively just a much larger mud hut, which inside is a much larger bullywog. Like, so massive that it probably can't move on its own.
Oh, ew. Like, Jabba, I'm picturing, like, the Goblin King from The Hobbit and Jabba the Hutt.
Except a frog person, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But slightly more froggy.
No, it's literally just make a frog stand on its back legs, and then you've got a bullywog.
Okay.
Yeah. And it's just sort of looking at you rather unimpressed. Why did you bring these things to me?
Talking to us?
Yeah.
It's not asking, it's...
No, it pointed at the two that you escorted, that, like, escorted you in. Like, why did you bring these to me?
We brought them to you because they led us to you.
Well, I have the biggest house. Why wouldn't you just come to the biggest house?
Because we saw some eyes in the muck first.
Well, just kill them. They already lost to you.
We only killed one of them.
Oh, so you just want us to execute them here and now.
I'm wondering why you didn't. They're no use to anyone.
I mean, we traditionally don't enter a village and just kill anything we see, but...
I mean, unless attacked first, but...
Are you not scaled? That's exactly what you do. That's exactly what we do.
I may be scaled, but I also bring.
Why
wouldn't have done anything for us.
We hear you have a hag problem.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And that means you have a hag problem.
So, tell us about this coven that's moved in. What do you know about them?
Don't know what you're talking about.
But we think you do, and you're hiding something.
Not wanting foreign invaders in my village? Yes.
Has there been anything weird happening? Unexplained things?
Well, a bunch of scale just walked 100 miles away from their empire to shoot one of my subjects.
Besides us, has there been anything out of the ordinary bullywog daily life?
Well, there's a 40-foot-wide tree that grew up over by the coast.
And since
that
this
just
tree
grew
has
there?
Grown,
that...
has there been any other odd occurrences?
I don't think so.
Has anyone from your village disappeared suddenly?
There were bullywogs. That's sort of the point.
Can you point us in the direction of the giant tree?
You can see it from outside the door.
How recently did this tree grow?
2 months ago?
Did it start tiny and get big, or did it just appear?
I don't know. We just looked outside one day and there was a giant tree.
So it just
We don't
appeared.
Go to the coast.
So it just appeared.
Salt water is bad for us.
Yep. Just appeared then.
All right. Well,
So we go to the tree?
Let's head to the tree.
All right.
Let's meet the nature.
I can't remember to spell bullywog.
So, yeah, we just walk out.
Okay. So just basically you literally walk outside and go, oh, that tree.
Can I do a nature check on the tree?
I mean, it's several miles away, but sure.
I'm gonna walk to the tree. Let's walk to the tree.
It is several miles away.
Pretty far.
Let's ride to the tree. Let us approach the tree.
Yeah, I saw. I'm trying to fix it right now. Okay. So the forest starts sort of re-thickening as you head closer and closer to the tree. Hang on, sorry. I'm trying to find... There it is. A thing to allow me to put links in my own chat, because I thought I turned this off. God damn it. To the point where the trees almost seem to be reaching over and scratching you off your own... off the wargs.
This... Okay, can I do a nature check?
On what?
The trees around us.
Sure.
To see if I notice anything kind of weird.
Sure.
Nice.
Do they seem unnatural?
They seem like totally normal trees that are just really pointy.
Okay. Useless nature check.
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay, sweet. We continue to ride towards the giant tree?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much.
Okay, do we reach the giant tree?
I mean, relatively shortly before you reach the giant tree, the path that you're following is basically blocked by trees. Very, very pointy trees.
Oh, so the forest gets so thick we can't go
any
further.
Like, it looks like the path just keeps going, but it stops being there. Like, it's just gone.
Just obliterated by trees.
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay.
Alright.
Oh.
So do we cut the trees down?
Does anybody have anything that would be really good at cutting down trees? Because all I have is my rapier.
Yeah, I just have a club and a crossbow, guys.
Anyone got anything to light the trees on fire?
Jiki pulls out a little hand axe.
That'll work.
Did Jiki ever get... I turned to Jiki, as, you know, I'm looking at my small armory upon my back, and ask about my magic sword.
Oh, he gave it back to you, and like that same night was just like, still not 100% sure what it does.
Do you have any idea what it does?
It's probably not bad to you.
Okay. Good. So probably my long sword would be the best option for...
I'm pretty sure an axe is probably the best option for chopping down a tree.
Well, I mean, besides the fact that none of us have... We'll just use Jiki's hand axe.
It's not even a big... It's like a throwing axe, basically.
Can I use Eldritch Blast to kind of force...
Oh my god!
It's a cantrip! It won't waste a spell slot.
You can try, yeah.
Go for it.
Okay, good luck.
Yeah.
Eldritch Blast the trees.
I mean, I'm going to assume that you're gonna... Does your just Eldritch Blast thing not work anymore?
Oh, I forgot I had the thing. Yep. Hang on.
I'm gonna assume that you can just hit the trees, though, so just roll me some damage.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh well, my god.
So essentially...
Did you kill it with one tree?
So essentially, there's just a large... thing of trees right in the center. Hang on, let me... turn on fog of war. There we go. There's basically just a clump of trees that are blocking the way that you want to go. and you just fire it directly into the center of that, and most of the, like, branches and things splinter out from different sides and are largely dealt with. However, on the very left and right sides, you're not quite so lucky. In fact, it seems like some... What the hell? Why won't you go down? There we go. Sorry, I'm putting people down onto the board before we start so that you'll actually be there. And some of you are trying to not get on the freaking board. And some of you, like Jiki...
Bless you.
Do not have a token, which is apparently going to make that an issue.
Can you just use Markle's token?
I can. I just need to actually put it down first.
Just so we don't forget about Jiki.
Just so what?
We don't forget about Jiki.
Yeah, I'm giving him a token. I just need to give him a token first. Bless you.
Bless you.
Up, dip, dip. Come on, I thought I had one here. But maybe not. There we go. That'll do. Make that one cheeky. Okay. Now then. Essentially... I don't know what is wrong with your audio, Stephanie, but it keeps being staticky.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean... Maybe
meet them there. There we go. So essentially, you blow open a small pathway in this forest, and oh shoot, the camera isn't here either because I have to fix the camera. Right, damn it.
Squeeze chimed in with 7-10 split.
Yep.
Pretty much.
Hello, massive camera. Shrink that down and put it right there. Okay. So, essentially, you all... I can't actually do a good way to show this because I don't have... I can't, like, fill these with color or anything because that would be too easy. Oh, wait, yes, I can. So you just blew open this tiny little path right through there. And unfortunately, instead of just blowing straight through the path, it looks like there are things that were totally standing there and are now rather angry that you tried to blow a hole in them.
Great.
Oops.
Oop, shit.
Yay.
Unfortunately, sweet. I did not have this one ready because I was not prepared.
Are they ants?
No.
How many of them are there? Six? I can count.
Yep, there are six of them. They appear to be... I know you can't really see them, but they appear to be almost humanoid. However... Like, they're humanoid-shaped, but they're definitely made out of the same pointy, horrible wood that the rest of them were from. One of them has now taken damage, but the rest are mostly just annoyed.
Did we just piss off some dryads?
No. You'd be dead if it was dryads.
Oh, thank God it's not dryads, then.
Yeah, exactly.
Could be worse.
This is a roll for initiative?
Pretty much, yeah.
All right.
Let's roll.
Oops, sorry.
Yeah, please don't do that.
Oof. Oh, dang it.
Boop.
I forgot to do the thing.
Good job.
Yeah. It's been a week.
I got my character.
See? What? Two of us have done it.
Just as you said that, I
okay, well, then... Sorry. You have to tell me what your actual things are so that I can add them to the turn order.
Wait. I'm at 14.
Whoa, and so I'm at 23.
I'm at 3.
We are not doing well.
No, not at all.
No.
Well, hang on a second, because I'm not done getting all of these guys ready yet. Because I didn't know how many of you all were going to run into. Da-da-da-da-da. Where's the original one? There it is. Come here, I need all your information over on this other screen. Okay. Turn order. None of you are in the turn order.
Nope.
Okay, there we go.
Are you guys still hearing static from my end, or is
nope.
it good now?
It seems good. To be good now. I'm not sure
okay.
what it was, but...
I don't know.
And the last one. Okay.
Hey, Steven.
Yeah.
Is there something that you've done so we can't actually click on our characters?
You broke it.
I don't think so. I just carried your normal characters in. Hang on.
Okay.
Who the hell am I looking at? That's Feline. There, do you want to try it, Feline, now? There, okay.
Cool. Yeah, for a second I was like, it's not letting me actually select my character.
Okay, well then do you want to roll your initiatives now then? Hmm. And see if that'll work.
There
oh,
we go.
Do you want to re-roll them?
Yeah.
Okay. Still really bloody high.
Aha, but I actually figured out how to roll initiative correctly for these buggers.
Needle blades.
Yeah, unfortunately there's no way to prevent you from getting their names, but whatever.
Okay. I mean, that doesn't do a whole lot for us.
Yeah. I still think I'm going first.
Nope. Well, what's your bonus?
Which bonus?
Your dex bonus, the only one that matters
oh,
for initiative.
Oh, sorry. Four.
Yeah, then you are going first.
Great.
There. So, you have four needle blights.
Sweet. Hang on, I just want to double check something. What is the mechanic that allowed me to smack it twice?
1v1.
You didn't get to smack it twice.
No, what was it? Hang on.
You got to add your sneak attack to something.
Thank you, that's what it was. I was trying to find it.
Yeah. Wasn't it like your buffoon
extra
bonus?
Yeah. If you're if you're attacking someone who has no one else within 5 feet of you. 5 feet of them.
Perfect. I'ma do the thing.
No, because all of them have something within 5 feet of them.
Oh. It's like an enemy.
It's an enemy or an ally.
Okay.
They can't have anyone and you can't have anyone near them.
Okay, then I'm going to move up to this first one, and I'm going to stab it with my rapier. Is that acceptable?
I mean, you have to actually give me the stats for your attempted stab.
I'm currently rolling it.
Yes, that will hit for 10 damage.
Sweet!
You're stabbing that one right there, who I haven't done health for yet?
Yes.
Well, damn it.
Stabby stab.
Okay, well, it's still alive, so don't worry.
Okay. I'm not good. I don't think I'm strong enough to do that much to it.
Okay, did I do all of their health? This one. I didn't do this one's health yet. Da-da-da. There we go. Okay, they all have health now.
Sweet.
So, up next is this one, who is going to fire off a barrage of needles at the guy who just tried to kill his friend.
Which one is this one?
The one in the back right corner.
Okay.
We just can't see.
Yeah. Does that... That 16
that
hits
does.
Your armor class, right?
Yep. Yeah. I think I am 14. Yeah.
Yeah, so give me 8 piercing damage.
Okay.
Mwahahaha. Up next is the one you just punched, who is also going to try and punch you right the hell back, because he's pissed now. Yes, everyone will now stand back and watch. Everyone, that is the rules.
Oh, man.
So, that's another 6 piercing damage. It's the second one. Very annoyed that you just put a rapier through its face. Proceeds to loudly scream, though in no particular words, and claw at your chest.
And it does damage.
Yeah.
Yay!
Then this one's going to move over and fire off another barrage of needles at you.
Wow! Okay. Should I roll a death saving throw now?
You at 12? Are you dead?
Yes. I was at 10.
You roll death saving throws on your turn.
Great. I'm at... Okay.
Wait, did you already full heal? Like, during our rest?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How much?
I just took 8, and 6 is 14, and then 14 and 12.
Oh, dear.
Is literally... all of my health.
Well, that one's going to notice that you're down, so he's just going to come around and fire off at one of you three.
Well, that sucked.
At Feline!
Okay.
I gotta get some new armor.
My armor class is 15. Does that still hit?
No, it... actually, I don't recall. Hang on. Let me check and make sure. Before I get this wrong, normally Defender wins ties, but I can't... I think in AC, Defender does not win ties.
Oh, no.
Hey, Feline, can you cast Mage Armor on another person?
Nope.
No, it's just me.
Darn it. I need to get some better armor.
I know, I'm just that selfish person.
Nope, attacker wins in this case.
Dang it. Okay. So... okie doke.
Okay, well, you're up next, so don't worry.
All right.
She already cast Mage Armor.
Yeah.
She was smart and did that way ahead of time this time.
Yay!
That was in the beginning.
Good.
Oops. All right. Am I able to move up here?
To where?
There.
You're going to incur an opportunity attack from every single one of them.
Ah, shucks. Don't do that. Okay. Right. I'll blast the one that just went after me.
Or okay. Just me.
Get back to my stats.
Don't come back over here. No.
Did you roll? You
roll. I rolled a net.
Nice.
You had to roll initiative for Jiki.
What?
Oh, did you miss Jiki?
You missed Jiki.
Yeah, I did. I rolled for Jiki. Okay, hey. I guess.
He's not on here?
It decided that I didn't do that. Sorry, I did actually roll initiative for Jiki.
Nice catch.
Topic is right. 7. We need a healer.
That's partially why Jiki's here.
Oh, yay! NPC to the rescue.
Yay!
Come here,
Jiki.
That's
good.
Damn it, Jiki. Come here. I need you to get way up here. Because you're definitely after Nadar. There we go.
No, I think Jiki's before me.
He has a plus... oh, yeah, I guess he is before you. Okay. So, yes, you're dealing... what is that? So 9 damage to which one?
The one that attacked me.
The one that attacked you? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So up next is Jiki, who is more concerned that you're all going to die if he doesn't do anything. Or if they don't
stabilize
do anything.
Stabilize the idiot.
No, they're going to throw a... vial that they quickly pull out of their satchel and chuck directly in between the four blights, who all now have to make a, what is it, a dex save? Yeah, a dex save.
I feel like their dex is all really high because of their...
One, two, three. Oh my god, he's about to kill all of them by accident. Four. Oh, for God's sake, he's about to kill all of them literally by accident.
Do I have to do a dex saving throw because I am right there?
No.
Okay.
Okay, so they all take the full 6 fire damage.
Sweet! Yay!
These two immediately burst into flames and fall to the grounds. And these other two just take 6. Once again, the ones that are on fire are loudly screaming, but again, in no particular language. And he's going to slither right up next to, not right there, to Moira. Nadar, you are up next.
Alright. Here so I can attack the one next to you and possibly the other one.
Okay.
I'm going to use... my dual wielding ability, so both of my long swords. So I'll swing the first one with my psionic stuff.
Okay.
so that's 6, right?
Yep. So and that's it, the one on your left or your right? Or forward or right?
Right.
Okay, that one is dead.
Alright.
Just cleanly cleaving in two.
And then I'm going to swing at the one in front now, which is also 6.
Okay. Also 6? Okay, that one is also dead. What the hell? Just murder all of my blights, sure.
It's a good thing.
I am murder machine, remember?
Apparently.
Seriously, you are.
Pretty great.
Okay, well, up next is one of the last needle blight that hasn't gotten to go yet, who is now very concerned about you murdering its friends, and is going to fire off a barrage of needles at you, which I'm pretty sure just bounce off.
Yep.
Yeah. Thankfully, that is the bottom of initiative, at which point something else is going to happen.
Oh.
Damn it, come here. Da-da-da-da-da. That one. 4. And I know that chat has been able to see this, but too bad. I did not have this prepared. Where did I put this one?
Oh dear, I'm worried
now.
I
put it somewhere else, that's where. Arr, there we go. So... revealed to you are... come on. Fucker. There we go. Several more blights. However, these ones are much smaller, about kneecap height.
I was like, they look different.
Yeah. These ones are not made out of needles or things. These ones appear to all be made out of twigs. And all enter basically at the very end of initiative. And proceed to realize that they can only move about 20 feet. So literally none of them can reach you. So they just sort of run screeching again about knee-level height towards you.
They're like evil baby Groots.
Yeah, I was about to say they're like baby mm-hmm. Groots.
Pretty much, yeah.
They're just cute.
But evil.
Except wildly screeching.
Oh my god, I just closed roll.
Oh.
I'm gonna cry. I'm so over today.
I'm sorry.
Right now, I just...
Exactly.
Yes, this is the baby group attack force, except literally evil. Moira, give me a death save.
Okay.
Good, I'm still in the turn order.
That is a success, yes.
Woo!
Yeah, death save is high is good, low is bad.
Okay,
It's literally a 50-50 thing.
Sweet.
Up next is the Needle Blight, who also concerned that someone recently just murdered two of his friends. well, friends is probably a strong word, but wow. Like, doesn't even ricochet off your armor like the last one. Just implants into the ground. Feline.
Alright. Remind me how acid breath works again.
It is a 15-foot cone. So, at the point that it is 15 feet away from you, can you see my ruler right now?
Yeah.
So, if you were to fire at Nadar, it would hit Nadar and Moira, because when it's at the cone, it hits these areas as well.
Gotcha. So if I went that way, it would hit these two too?
You would need to move, because that's 20 feet away
from those two. Oh, that's 20 feet. Ah, I can still move. Merp. Alright.
Yeah, acid you could definitely get all of those with an acid breath, yes.
Alright. Well.
Oh, okay, that's just rolling weird stuff. Yeah. Oh, none of that is correct.
Did that not work?
No.
Okay, that's what was on the sheet.
I think that may have been done by accident. Okay. So it's 2d6 okay. damage.
Should I roll a d20 first?
No, because that one doesn't hit. It's a... They have to roll a con save.
Yeah.
2d6. 8.
Okay, well, let's... Where did I put the twig blades? I've already lost them because I'm smart like that. They all have to make con saves, which I don't actually know. What is your con bonus?
Three.
Okay, so 3 + 8 = 11, +2 is... So they need to be 13.
13.
Okay. So there's one.
Fail.
There's two. There's three.
They all failed.
They all failed. If they had succeeded, they'd still be dead. Don't worry. Woo. So okay. All three of those blights fall into a puddle of acid now, just suffering and continuing to scream the scream of death.
Oh, that's a lot of acid rain.
That's not even rain. That's just directly under their feet now. Jiki is going to pry open your mouth and pour a healing draught down your throat.
Aw, thank you.
For 4 healing. Because mold's literally the worst.
I'm not complaining, because I can access my med bag now.
Better than a 1.
Yes.
Nadar, you're up.
Alright. Move up here. Swinging swords again.
Oh, they're gonna get their asses beat.
You literally just walk up and very casually cleave off the head of one of the blights.
You are like tanky.
No, not tanky.
No, damage-y. Murdery. Tanky damage-y. Is take damage.
Yeah, no, I'm damaged.
No, you murderer. You just murderer. Murder train. You are the captain of the murder train.
That miss?
That will miss, yeah.
A tiny miss?
Yeah.
Okay.
Captain of the murder train.
The second one, the blight basically sort of deflects with its weird wooden arm. Which means that it's up for an attempted attack. Which, because you're right up close, it has to do a claw. Pretty sure that still doesn't quite hit.
Nope.
Yeah. So that's the end of initiative, which means it's the Twig Blight's turn! Which means they're going to run up and try and beat the snot out of two of you at shin height.
Thank God you're stabilized.
So the first two are going after Moira, because she's stabilized. So there's one.
Yay!
There's Mrs. two.
Misses!
And the third is going after Jiki, who also misses.
You can't spell... I don't think you spelled claw right.
No, I didn't. Not on that one, yeah.
Claws.
Okay, do you want to make 8 different character sheets? Every week?
Nope. Not really.
Okay. I didn't mean to delete that one, but whatever. Moira, you're up.
I'm going to use my med kit to try to stabilize myself real quick.
That is not something you can really do in combat.
Okay. Then I'm going to move. How far can I move? Let's go right here, 25 feet away. Let's scooch out of the way.
Okay.
And just so I'm not close enough to be, like, clawed. And then I'm going to shoot the one directly in front of me with my short bow.
Okay. That will hit and kill it.
Yay!
Thaline, you're up. After watching one of the blights now just fall to an arrow straight through its, well, not skull.
Awesome. I'm going to use Chill Touch on, I guess, the one next to Cheeky.
Okay.
Did it work? It did.
That one should have had a roll on it.
Weird.
So give me a d20 to see if it hits.
Yeah.
You should have a +4, I want to say.
+4.
Oh, yeah.
So
that,
18.
That definitely hits. So that's another one down.
Woohoo!
Yay! And it's
Cheeky's
turn.
Cheeky is actually just going to run away from it because it's still... they're still trying to heal the idiot that's damaged. So, going to invoke an opportunity attack, but... oh, and it hits.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
For 3.
Gothic, we don't need a healer. We're fine.
actually.
Well...
give me a damn second to find out how much this is about
dead.
To be.
Three of us, Gothic. I have healing abilities.
I have a med kit.
No,
yes,
really.
That only does stabilization.
Yeah.
The point of the the point of the healer rogue is to give you the healing potions so you can put them in people. But you have none of you have gone out of your way to make money to get healing potions.
I tried. There were 75 gold.
That's less than they're supposed to be.
Oh, don't.
Really?
Yeah.
Jeez.
It's literally a magic potion that heals you. What were you expecting?
I don't know.
There's no concept of
something a little more affordable.
Okay. So, 1d8 plus... let me check his spellcasting ability modifier. Come here, Cheeky. It's annoying me now. I didn't realize that his name sounded so much like Geeky Geeky. So that might be a thing I need to change later.
Okay.
For 7 hit points to you.
Yay! I'm at 11 out of 26.
And that is one of their spell points.
Thank you.
Yeah, Bleak Visage. Clearly, no healing needed. Just murder. Just murder. Nadar, would you like to murder some things?
Yeah, I want to kill
Nadar, do a murder!
Alright, so we're going to do... I'm at 14 for 8. So 15 for 9.
Yeah, that will definitely hit. But it's remarkably still standing. You basically just... shoved your not magic sword through its...
5 for 7. How about now? Is it dead?
So basically, magic sword through chest. Not magic sword. Lop the head off for good measure. Yes, it's dead.
Yay!
No, not magic sword through chest, then magic sword, lop head.
Okay, fine. Up next is the other twig blade, who is going to desperately try and suicide into one of you then. It's going to try and hit Feline. Yeah, I didn't do the Kiki Jiki thing on purpose, but now it's annoying me because I didn't notice it initially. I don't think that hits you, so it was worth a try.
Yeah.
Okay, well, there's 2 damage.
Bleak
that doesn't
visage,
do anything.
I am murder machine.
Clearly. Moira, you're up.
I'm going to shoot it with my short bow.
Okay.
Yeah, don't make me have to come back down there.
Yeah, that's dumb.
Yay, it's dead now.
Okay. Well, with that, you've basically blown open this path to...
To where?
To the massive tree. Which means that you are all now over on a completely separate page that I have not revealed to anyone yet.
Oh boy. What?
Da, 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 da. I didn't actually want to have any of this hidden, but whatever. Ta-da.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So you're not exactly clear on what the hell you're looking at beyond that. Okay. Real quick, simple explanation if I can help it. Circle is the giant S tree.
Okay.
That's a big tree.
It is a very big tree. In fact, if you measure it, it is 50 feet across.
Oh, Jesus.
That's a really big tree.
What about all these little things?
They're basically... So you're not able to tell what they are beyond that they are some sort of, like, freshly dug hole or something.
That can't be bad.
Scattered across the entire... area, and the tree is basically growing into a shallow bit of ocean.
Hmm. Interesting. While we're standing here, can I use my healer's tools?
You can try, but again, that's not what they're intended for.
No, but I don't really have any other way to, like, gain...
You could take a rest.
Actually, Moira, come here.
Okay.
I'm
not sure where I am right now.
I'll put you all down in just a damn second.
She said come here.
Yeah, and I am putting you down in a second.
I mean, just theoretically, come here.
You don't need to physically move.
Yeah.
Thank you, Cervanti2K, for following.
Oh, hey, there's a new person who joined chat. Bleak Visage.
Yep.
Visage.
Yep, we talked to him. That is Joey.
Hello. Oh, okay. Hi. Right.
And there's Nadar.
Moira.
Yes.
You gained 9 points back.
Sweet. That's a lot better. I'm now at 20 out of 26.
Good.
That's a lot more doable.
There, you're welcome.
Thank you.
Da, 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 da. HP, yes. Okay.
See, I has healing abilities.
Well, just for my sanity.
Oh, hold on.
Dog.
The dog is fleeing! The dog is fleeing!
No, dog is coming in.
Ah.
Stay out.
Well, fleeing from the out.
Incoming
there.
Dog.
Sorry, I just want to make sure I have all of your health up for at least me to see, and by extension... the stream to be able to see all of your health bars. So yes, that is clearly the tree. You don't see any immediately accessible way into it, though on some of the higher levels you can definitely see that there are, like, windows carved in it with torches or some sort of fire burning on the inside that hasn't engulfed the entire tree, so it's probably just lighting.
So there are people living in the tree.
Which can only mean bad juju. Also, because does anybody notice the piles of dirt around us?
Those can't be good.
I'm fixing their size, sorry.
Much bigger
piles. That's
a lot
bigger.
Yeah, sorry,
that's
I forgot.
That's a big pile of dirt.
That was just like little clusters.
Nope.
I was like, oh, they planted things. Mm-hmm. That's like, what, 10? 10 and 10?
Yeah, that is 10 by 10.
Wow.
That's
Yes, clearly, yeah. Clearly these are just the Keebler elves living in a tree making cookies with really bad marketing.
Wasn't there a witch who made a hut out of gingerbread?
The one in Hansel and Gretel? Yes.
Yes, maybe these are their friends.
But you're looking for hags, not witches.
No.
Hags aren't human, they're like fey beings.
Okay.
This is some bad juju. Can we do a perception check on the dirt?
I mean, you'd have to get much closer to one of them, but sure.
I don't like the looks of this.
Can I move over just a little bit?
Yeah.
I'm just
If you press that, you can actually move your entire character sheet over to a separate window.
That's right. I did this last time, and I forgot how.
And then you can make it bigger so you can see all this stuff.
I can see 98% of
this. I'm just saying, you can make it easier on you. So yes, what are you all looking to do?
How close would I have to get?
Like 15 feet?
Like
or
there?
Stand on one?
I don't want to stand on that.
Yeah, so, yeah, that's what I'm saying, is you'd have to be like right next to it.
Okay.
Okay. It is a pile of loose dirt.
Can I make an arcana check?
I was hoping someone would.
Yeah.
So are you trying to, like, feel magic in the air, I guess?
Yeah.
Okay, then
in
sure.
The air, in, like, the holes, in the dirt.
Okay, you can try.
There
it is. I'm gonna move.
Holy balls, there is a lot of magic going on here. It's actually kind of painful to feel.
Oh.
So,
the
tree is definitely grown with magic, though it's not mortal magic. There's nothing immediately magical about the like, filled-in holes or anything. Though, there is an overwhelming magic sort of expanding outwards from the tree. Beyond that, there isn't anything particularly magical. Like, there are definitely magical beings inside the tree, but no, the holes themselves aren't magic. The tree is grown by magic, but is not innately magic.
Alright. Tree is magic, and...
Is there a door?
Yeah, there's people in the
trees.
Oh, and most of the... There are, like, woods around this area. And those are definitely all feel to be touched by some sort of dark magic as well. Similar to what you felt around the Blights.
Can I use my Wand of Secret for secret doors?
Remind me what exactly that says it does.
It opens secret doors.
Is that all? Does it have a range or anything that I gave you?
It opens secret doors, expended as an action, 3 charges, and it gains 1d3 at dawn.
Hang on, let me actually check and see.
One of its charges, it gains its charges back at dawn.
Yeah. Let me see here. Oops, too far.
I got really excited, because Haley said secret door, and I'm like, I can do a thing!
One of secrets while holding... It, so no, because you didn't write down what I read to you, it's, while holding it, you can use an action to expend one of its charges. If a secret door or trap is within 30 feet of you, the wand pulses and points at the one nearest to you. Yeah.
It doesn't open secret door.
No. So, if you would like to expend a charge and see if there is one within 30 feet of you, then you can do that.
I might hang on just a sec, once my cursor stops doing the whole rainbow wheel.
I'm just trying to figure out what exactly 30 feet away from you is.
Yeah, I'm going to use that, then.
There is no magic in a young girl's heart, Squee, that's horrible. I mean, are you going to use it right where you're standing, or what?
I'm going to move up, let's see. I'm going to move up 10 feet and use it. So, 30.
Okay.
Okay.
So if you use it, it's going to point you directly to that way.
Okay. Okay, so that makes... I have 2 charges left on this. Okay. So there might be either a door or a trap this way. I point.
Well,
or I gesture to where my wand is pointing.
Jiki? Should we go?
Jiki's just like... And, like, pulls out his, their slate and writes, I'm like, I am a researcher. I'm just backup.
Well, you're also here as part of the party. So if you think it's a bad decision to go inside, we want to know.
I'm afraid that it's a trap, not a door.
Kind of have to agree on with Jiki on this one.
Me too.
It's a thing.
No. Yeah.
Sadly, it doesn't show me which.
No, it does not.
So is there any way to go up and not hate our lives?
Oh, wait a minute.
You have trap checking devices?
It's called a rogue.
Oh, sneaky sneaky.
No, yeah. No, it's called con-based trap detection, and you send the rogue in, and if they die, there was a trap.
What? Aw, I don't like that.
You literally found the only other trap that I've used.
No, it's me.
Oh.
No, you found a trap. She triggered a trap.
Oh, that's right!
Yeah, I fell in a hole. Because I thought it was a good idea to enter the room without looking first.
Technically, for 5e Squee, that's how everyone checks for traps. No one has a check for trap skill. That's why whenever they say, I want to check for traps, I ask, what are you looking for?
Okay, I'm going to keep trying to use this. Can I use the mage hand to try and, like, feel around? Or would that be considered?
Feel around where? Because you can only do it in line of sight. So you can't do it, like, inside the tree.
That's true.
Could she touch against the tree?
Yeah. Like, pat around it? See if I can activate something?
Sure.
Unless that'd be considered magic.
No, that's fine, but you'd have to get within, I think it's 30 feet.
Okay.
If you come stand next to me, I think you're within 30 feet.
Yeah.
Boop. Okay.
Are you patting around the secret door entrance?
Yeah.
I use strong air quotes for reasons.
Yes, I am. Shall I roll a d20?
Yes. Just roll a perception check.
That is a thing.
Oh, bad juju.
Why?
You are absolutely certain there is nothing here.
Well, guys.
Which means there's totally something there.
Yeah.
Last time somebody said there's absolutely nothing there, we found something. So I don't trust that.
Yeah, don't trust my judgment on this.
I'm sure you say it with complete conviction, though, so... I'm just going back on...
No, you're 100% certain of this.
Yeah, I'm just going back on, last time somebody said, there's nothing here, I found something there, so...
Great. Anything I can do?
Any other ideas, guys?
I mean, the only thing that I can think of is go up and touch the door, but that doesn't sound like a good idea.
Do you have another idea?
No.
Half of me says, go in, kick down the door, and then the other half of me is like, that's a bad idea.
I mean, as long as no one gets pissy about having to heal me, I'll go and touch the door.
Gee, I don't know who you're talking about.
I mean, come on. Either that or I shoot the door with something or throw a knife at it.
Jiki is going to, like, back away farther, but hold up a slate that says, go touch the door.
Thanks, Jiki.
I have a bunch of temporary hit points. I can go and touch the door.
You took a rest. You didn't kill anything.
Yes.
We did.
Oh, right.
The tree people.
Well, did you kill them?
Killed four.
Oh,
three with the acid breath, and then...
Right, yeah, I forgot about the acid breath. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Do you want to go and touch the door, Feline?
Well, since I'm so sure that there's nothing there,
you might as well go.
Let's do it.
She ignores all our comments and sees Jiki, and she's like, yeah, I'm with Jiki. Here, this one.
I'll go with you.
Rush to the door.
Kay. Here, I'll be right here.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, I poke the tree.
Okay. It feels like poking a tree.
All right. I will feel around for something.
It feels like tree bark.
Is there like a knot hole or anything you can press into?
Give me a perception check.
Oh. I'll move up and...
Not you. You're not there. I'm asking Feline to give me a perception check.
I'm making that suggestion.
You know how good I am at perception checks.
Yeah, give me a perception check.
Yeah!
You've got great perception checks.
I'll say that Feline is... Hang on. I'm going to say that you have advantage because Moira is attempting to give you advice. She is performing the help action, even if not well, which means you have advantage.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay, that is better. It feels like a tree.
Great, guys. We got a tree.
Can I try climbing the tree up to a window?
There aren't really any good handholds, but you can try.
Would that be acrobatics?
Don't you have an actual climbing speed?
I might. Hang on. Because you picture me more like a lizard climbing up walls.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure lizard folk have a climbing speed thing.
Okay, hang on just a sec.
Bleak, last time we tried to burn the trees, that went really badly for us.
Sneak climbing and looking in a window.
We tried to burn the trees. Feline got one damage, and we pissed off a bunch of blights. So maybe let's not.
I'm not gonna do any burning. I just wanted to look.
You have swimming speed, so if you are climbing, you're gonna be climbing at half speed. But yes, you can try and do it stealthily.
Okay, so.
But it's. It's gonna take you like a full minute or two to make it all the way up.
Okay, are you guys going to be making bets on how I fall? Or something? In that minute?
No. You're making stealth checks, not...
Okay.
Not acrobatics checks to see how badly you fail.
Okay.
Is this a halfsy thing?
No.
Oh. Sorry, I asked before I realized you were putting your dice.
Yeah.
Up to the tree.
Okay. So you were climbing up the tree trying to reach a window.
Yes, to peer into it.
Okay. You reach a window after almost a solid 2 minutes of climbing.
Okay.
In it, you can see a remarkably ugly-looking woman, but looks pretty much what you would expect a human to probably look like. At least from all the things you have heard about what humans should look like. Just a very ugly, very skinny, gaunt one.
Okay, can she see me?
No, she is talking to a relatively large bugbear.
Awesome! Can I hear what they're saying?
No, from what you can see, it looks like she is giving him commands, but you can't actually see anything that they're doing.
Okay. I'm going to climb back down the tree.
Okay, what is your passive perception?
I believe it's 13. Yeah, 13. Okay.
So just climbing back down the tree?
Yeah, I'm going to climb back down the tree to the bottom.
Okay.
And go back to the group and explain what I see, what I saw, what I have seen.
Okay.
Wow, tenses are hard today. Back down the tree. Go away. Over here. And I kind of motioned everyone to come, like, talk. And I relay what I saw. So everybody knows what I saw.
Well, Haley, did you have an earbud in? Okay, so you couldn't actually... Oh, wait, no, I said it, so you can hear it.
I heard yeah. most of it. I heard humanish, or what we might know to be a human. Thin? Did you say they were thin?
Very thin and like, gaunt and ugly.
Okay.
Very,
and then there
very
was also
ugly.
An ugly woman?
Yeah, and talking to a bugbear and seeming to give it orders.
But not the chief, right?
No.
Okay.
All right, so is that what a hag looks like, then?
You all have seen.
I don't remember.
You all have seen a hag, and they did not look human.
Okay.
But you've only seen one kind of hag, so you don't really know. But it
if
looked
that
like
that is what a human look like. Looks like they are ugly. No scales, no crests, no nothing. Just kind of weird colored. No tails.
Just fleshy.
Disgusting.
Just kind of looks like the underbelly of a warg.
Gross.
That is not how I was expecting you to go with that, but okay.
She's not gifted with speech.
So, Mr. Researcher, what do you want to do with that information?
They start to write something on their slate, and then looks up. And it's just like looking up the tree to where Moira had been, and their mouth just sort of falls open in what looks like it probably would have been a curse if they could talk.
I'm gonna turn around and look at the tree.
Yeah,
this doesn't sound good.
Moira, you turn around about in time to basically feel what you can't really describe, but feels like an inky black. Just disgustingness pour over you. And I don't believe you get a save against this, but let me make sure.
What is this?
Do, 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 do.
So I take it they did see me?
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
Give me a wisdom saving throw. Yeah, that is not good enough.
So what happens?
Okay.
I hope not, Squee. I hope not.
That would be disturbing.
The woman that you could see when you were up there sort of quietly chanted to herself, and as you were listening, you could actually hear two other... female, very monkey-ish voices also chanting quietly along with her from different parts of the tree.
Oh, damn it!
And when I say quietly, I mean it sort of spread slowly, but even though you could tell it was a good while up the tree, you could still hear it perfectly fine. Just a sort of a low rumble. Hello, Magic Slinky.
Thank you.
And yes, basically... You could only describe it as sort of a black sludge-like feeling, just like a disgustingly viscous liquid pouring down you after slapping you in the face.
Yeah.
And you have been cursed.
Oh, bad juju, 100% bad juju. We can use all
no one was doing anything. I figured climbing the tree was a good idea.
You have...
What does the curse do?
You have a disadvantage and... a disadvantage to anything that is going to use dex. Either for a roll or for a save.
Uh-huh.
Including your attacks.
Shenanigans. Okay. Wow!
Right. So, I can't do my short bow... Or get a disadvantage on my short bow.
Yeah.
So we can't really do anything.
She can't.
Darts.
Do well, I mean,
well, I've got darts and daggers.
How far did she climb?
Both of which use dex.
So I'm kind of useless right now.
How far up the tree did she climb?
Probably about 40 feet up.
I don't think there's a lot we can do right now.
Not really. I mean, you still haven't found a way in.
True. Any suggestions from the peanut gallery?
It's just sort of looking at Moira and trying to figure out, like, looking at you going, I'm... And, like, writing down on the slate, like, I don't know how to remove a curse.
Okay. That probably means it's time to not be here anymore. Because if they can curse us from, like, 40 up and, what, 15?
Yeah, because we're about, what, how far from the tree?
So that's 60 feet? So 40 up and 20 across. They can curse us from 60 feet. And we don't know how to get in there to beat the crap out of them. Because I is murder machine, but I need to beat things to be a murder machine. Yeah. So, we don't have Morgul here, which is a problem. Because he was our tanky tank. We don't have a tanky tank without him. Should we go back and report information? Because this was an intel check?
With that, a small... You would almost call it a doorway, but it sort of reminds you of when the last hag you dealt with just sort of opened a small doorway in air walked through.
Doorways in air, bad things. No.
With the bugbear chief. It looks relatively similar, but there's no hag on the other side. And three, what appear to just be, like, scarecrows, step through, basically between you all and the exit that you forcibly created last time, or when you came in here.
Climbing the tree was a bad idea.
I mean, we didn't really have another option. This was an intel thing, so...
No, we didn't, and I did get intelligence, but somehow got my stupid ass cursed.
But they're just sort of standing there, staring at you.
I don't suppose you're here to talk... I say out loud.
They continue to stare at you.
So they're in the way of the path we made. We can't get past them without meeting them.
Pretty much, yeah.
So essentially we have to go in through the door.
What door?
No, they came out of a door.
No.
Oh.
A door...
In space.
I'm describing it as a door because there's no better way to put it. Just sort of a shimmer in the air. The other side of it looked relatively similar... to the inside of the tree that you saw, but only relatively. They just walked through it, and then it went away behind them.
Got it. Any suggestions, anyone?
Oh, God damn it, let me take this stupid thing away.
Well, we want to go back. We're going to have to get through those scarecrows. Either that or go and try and find another entrance to that tree.
I think going into the tree is bad juju.
They're basically not moving. They're just standing there blocking your way.
So...
Right now they are.
What if I go up and hit it?
I don't know. Are you going to go up and try and hit it?
I mean, we're not going to get out if we don't get past them, so... So, sure. I'll go up and hit it. This is going to be really bad, but I'm doing it anyway because we're not hearing any objections from the peanut gallery.
There's not much else we can do. And...
Okay.
Nope. Go for it.
Great.
Me trying to do stuff has been ending really badly.
It just continues to, like, look straight at you.
If I get close enough, it just stares.
Yeah, it's just staring.
Did you hit it?
No, I'm thinking. I just push his back out.
Squee has pointed out that you're at war with trees. This game is anti-environmental propaganda.
He's on to us.
Pretty much.
There.
At least you're only at war with literally evil trees.
Well,
and
in
angry
our defense,
scarecrows.
We are lizard-ish people. We're not humans.
You are all evil aligned in some way.
Mm-hmm.
Quiet. Hmm. Alright, fine. I'm just gonna hit swords and stuff. Wait, no, that's not what I wanted. Cancel. This is gonna go badly. I know it is. We're doing it anyway.
Okay.
So I hit it for...
22?
20... Wait, yeah, 22.
No,
23.
23, yeah. 23. Okay. Well, suffice to say, they're now relatively pissed, and are now all rolling initiative, because they weren't going to attack you, but I guess now they have to. So Let me actually open the turn order. There we go. Oops, shit. That last one didn't really roll. There we go. Ah! Hi there, 20.
Oh, okay. I liked its last roll better.
I rolled a 20 as well.
Well, you didn't click on yourself for it.
Alright, shall I re-roll it again then?
No, but next time, if you don't click on yourself, I'll make you re-roll it.
Alright.
And then...
Okay. Is that everyone?
Yes.
Except for Jiki, who... No, wait, I have a Jiki roll.
Moira. We're missing a Moira.
Oh, okay, I know why. Because I couldn't click on Moira for some reason. There. You're supposed to have 20. Jiki has not rolled yet. You're supposed to have 20. Where are you? There you are, Jiki. And give me an inch. Fuck. Okay. There. So, the order is... Feline is up first.
Alright. See what I can do. Ian?
Hit the one I hit for a lot of damage.
Yeah, let's do that. Go blast him.
Some Eldritch Blast?
Yeah. What I rolled.
Okay, you're hitting the one.
Oh.
You're hitting the one that Nadar already hit?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, Moira, you're up.
I tried.
Okay, I'm gonna move forward and stab it.
Stabs it?
Stabs it.
Okay.
And I believe that is not dex.
All of your weapons are dex.
Great, so disadvantage?
I mean, you can choose to use strength for all of them, but your strength is way worse.
Yeah. Okay.
That will not hit.
Cool. Yep.
Up next is which scarecrow? That scarecrow. Hi, buddy! Hi!
Misses.
But what about the second one?
Both of them hit me?
No. They attacked twice.
Oh, lovely. Okay.
So...
And I need a wisdom save from you. That's fine. You did not fall. Did not fail. But
do I take all the damage?
Yes.
Sweet.
Well, sometimes it's not all damage if you save.
Yeah, that's why I have what the save does in there. Jiki is up next and is a little bit perturbed that they can't now throw another fire grenade. So they're just gonna fire at the one that hit you. With the Thundermonger. And hit for... What is that? 18, but minus 5, minus, and then I hate math. Okay. Up next is the other scarecrow, which is forced into combat now with Moira. And I think both of those miss, right?
Nope.
The first one hits?
Yep.
Okay, then I need another wisdom save. That does not save.
So I'm frightened and I take 5 damage.
Yep. So you have to spend your next turn trying to get away from them. You can use your action as a disengage so you don't get opportunity attacks, though.
Sweet.
Nadar, you are up next.
Alright. I'm gonna swing at the one in front of me. That misses. So I'm gonna take my second.
That does not miss.
No?
Not with your plus one, no.
Oh, okay. So I hit for 10?
Okay.
On that first one.
That one is for 10? Okay. And then the second one will kill it.
Awesome.
Basically, as soon as you touch it with the second attack, the scarecrow just sort of falls down into a lump of just weird clothing and hay. With sort of, like, firelight. You can only describe it as, like, firelight seeping back out of it.
Weird.
Okay. Feline.
What does that say? Plus 10.
Hmm?
Alright. Sorry. I'm gonna use Chill Touch.
Okay.
Oh. Keep forgetting. Alright. Heh.
That should not be plus 10.
No, why is that? Ugh, I put plus 4.
Well, because you probably added a plus when it didn't actually need it. Let me check. You are Feline.
Yep.
It's under your spells or under your...
Oh, under the attacks.
Do-do-do-do-do. Okay, well, one, that is... So this should be... Oh, that shouldn't be adding any damage. And... Charisma plus... Oh, okay, I know the issue now. Okay, now it is fixed.
My bad, guys.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, now you can roll it and it'll be correct.
Woo!
And much better.
Nice.
Okay, I can do that.
Yeah, so which one are you firing at, by the way?
Let's do the lowest one.
The lowest health one?
No, I think it's the physically lowest one. Like,
okay.
Yeah, on the map.
Okay.
Because you can't see its health.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, I mean, some of you might be tracking how much damage they've taken.
No.
Up next, Moira.
Who's trying to disengage?
Disengage. And...
You must use your maximum move to run away.
All done.
Okay, can you roll me a d6 real quick? Okay. Scarecrow is up next. Which one is that? That is that one. Going to move up to Nadar, because you're scary and you just murdered a scarecrow.
Ugh.
Well, sometimes they can hit, and sometimes they can't.
Make a wisdom throw?
Yep, wisdom save.
Great.
Yeah, you just click on that one. Yep, you passed it, don't worry. You are not terrified of the clearly terrifying scarecrow that just tried to claw off your face. Up next is Jiki, who now actually can throw that whole the fire bottle thingamahoos it directly in between the two. So they need to make their dex saves. Let's see if they can. One. And two. Okay. The bottom one totally saves by some sort of miracle. This one takes... And this one takes... Five. Okay. That was pretty much all Jiki had this turn, though, so... Second Scarecrow is going to run up and try and beat him to death because of it. Okay. It's basically going to get one of its arms stuck in some of the mechanisms for Jiki's weapon and end up sort of tearing its own secondary arm off. The first arm still doesn't quite manage to deal any damage, though. So, up to Nadar.
Alright, I'm gonna dash its face in with some swords. Hopefully.
That'll hit.
So, six.
And that'll hit. Yep, so once again, the two-part beatings just sort of slice the thing apart. Up next is Feline. Who I think at this point you're probably getting annoyed because you've watched as the Scion murdered two of the things already.
Taking all your hit points.
Let's do... I don't know. I'm just going to move up to it and start hitting it with the club.
Did you ever feed the club?
No. I kept forgetting.
Feline,
even after you said something.
Feline has a magic item that is actually pretty good, but requires being fed meat for it to do anything. Right now it's just Right now it's just quietly being angry at her.
Because I won't feed it.
That will hit for 11 bludgeoning damage.
Whew.
My brain went 12, and I'm like, wait, it's not.
Yeah, no, I already did the... She already has her plus one bonus added, because it's always on. Moira, you are up next. You are no longer having to flee, don't worry.
I'm trying to think of what I can actually... you know what, I'm gonna try using my short bow. Maybe it does something?
Yay, me. Hey, Chewie.
Chewie?
Yep.
Let's see. On a disadvantage... Can I do anything? No.
Not quite. Close, but not quite. I'm going to scroll up real quick just so the chat can actually see what this magic item's description is, because it's very long. I don't think I can actually show all of it. But basically, she has a very strange mace that is the symbol of a goblin god. And if she shoves meat into the weird... crevice in it, the mace will do some extra bonus stuff for her.
It's really good. I just keep forgetting to beat it.
Up next is Jiki, who has no melee weapon. Well, who has crap melee weapons, so is going to actually just use their gun with disadvantage. And not do the monger one, because that might kill all of you.
I appreciate that. Oh.
However, the gun is definitely going to jam.
Because of its thing in there?
Yeah, because they're trying to fight with it in melee range, and that apparently didn't go very well, so it has jammed. Up next is the Scarecrow, who is going to try and follow up on this whole, hey... That thing's weapon is broken. And apparently royally screwed up.
Oh.
There we go! One of those got
in.
For, what is that? Three damage. Okay, well...
My turn.
No, Jiki has to make his wisdom save.
Damn it.
Which he is not good at.
Damn it.
And he has failed.
Damn it, Jiki.
No.
Nadar! Yep.
He
Oh, for God's sake. I don't know why I keep putting enemies in front of you, but okay. Okay, so that's minus 10, or minus 11. Okay.
11.
That meets the AC and is enough to kill it. God damn it.
Yes! So, I have single-handedly wiped out all the scarecrows!
However, Jiki did not see you kill it, and is going to run... Oh, shit. 30 feet that way.
Oh, bad juju.
Jiki, where are you going?
Running the hell away, because he's scared of the scarecrow that just died. Can someone roll me a d6?
Anybody doing it, or do I need to?
Oh, here.
Yeah. No, the mace is not called Bite and Smite, unfortunately. It is called... What is it called?
Again, with the good names, do you just, like... Do you do this for a living, Squee?
I mean, Squee is in marketing.
That makes so much more sense.
There you go.
Club so of... So much more sense. I hate this god's name so much. Maglubinyet. It's literally like a headsman's axe that got stuck in the stone that was being used as the chopping block, and you have to put the meat into the crevice in between them. And then it eats.
The fact that Squee works in marketing, everything just makes so much more sense now.
I think he works in marketing.
Do
you
work in marketing?
Well, apparently you have a new name for your mace, if you want to call it that. It might not be happy about it, but...
The Bite and Smite?
It's already not happy with me, so...
By the way, Steven, I rolled a 5 for that 1d6 that you wanted.
Yeah, I saw.
Okay.
So.
Okay, good. I'm not crazy. He does work in marketing. Yeah, so with that... this combat has largely ended. Your path is free. And you have unintentionally now... proven that most of these are just dirt clods that you all ran over.
Oh, good.
Because all of you got feared over or near all but two of them.
So, we now move on home? To go away? I want to go away. Do you guys want to go away? I think we should go.
I'd like to spend some time thinking about my curse. How to get rid of it. I mean, does it have a time limit?
It does. You're not eminently aware of it, but... Essentially... well, not Moira. Feline, as a warlock and someone who casts Curse, theoretically...
I was just about to ask if I can do a check on it.
Sure. Give me an Arcana check with advantage.
Doop, doop. Touch. 10.
You do not know the spell Curse, do you? Or Bestow Curse?
No, I don't think so, no.
Okay. It's just a normal, like, decent warlock spell. You know enough about it to know that a curse can go on without an endpoint, but... From what you're able to feel out about this spell, it was just sort of a spiteful revenge. Like a, effectively, we let you climb the tree, now we get to punish... Now here's what you get for climbing the tree. Or what the trade is. So, wait, it took you about...
Do I know? Go ahead.
You get the feeling that it probably will last about as long as it took Moira to climb up and back down the tree.
So 2 minutes, no, let's see.
Like four minutes? Probably, yeah.
It's okay.
What?
So I wouldn't worry about it too much.
You entered into a bargain with a fae. You just weren't aware of it.
What? But? Shall we head back?
To where?
To... Marvel?
I mean,
gave us this information in the first place.
Sorry, chat. Gotta read them terms of use. I mean, Jiki's gonna sort of look at you all like, and write on their slate, well, what have we learned?
That there are ugly, creature-y things. Working
there
with bugbears.
Bugbears with said ugly, ugly, creature-y things. Oh, he's gonna suggest we go in the door. Try to find a way in the trees.
We didn't really learn too much.
Yeah, Jiki just writes down like,
enough to go back.
That's not new information. And it's like half a day's ride back. We might as well set up camp not right here.
Okay.
Yeah, let's do a rest. 'Cause I'm at 6 hit points.
Yeah.
I'm gonna lose all my temper.
You're very, very squishy.
Is there a way to up my armor class? 'Cause I don't know if there is.
Yes, get better armor.
I thought I could only have light armor.
Money.
Yes, there's more than one kind of light armor.
Okay.
You just haven't been looking for it.
Fair enough.
So
let's go take a camping break.
Yeah. What do you think? A mile should be good enough? Far enough away from this?
Jiki sort of like nods in great agreement as soon as you say a mile away.
Alright.
Perfect.
Alright. Let's go. Oh. That's very Chusqui.
Yes, that is very, very true. Unfortunately,
that would be a good one too.
Yeah, except that you keep running into the fighting.
Yeah,
that's not good. I'm a swashbuckler with no common sense.
Yeah, it's kind of an issue, especially since swashbuckler also gets bonuses based on charisma.
Which really?
I also don't have.
Hi, bad Miriam.
I thought it'd be cool. I obviously didn't think that through long enough.
No, 100% no.
I know. I gotta stop playing like characters that
I'm
not.
I'm kind of squishy, but I at least, if I get
you've
into
got
battle,
good armor.
No, if I get into battle, I build up temporary hit points every round of combat.
I don't have anything like that, so.
Okay, let me just check to make sure. First of all, I think when you get to higher swashbuckler level, you get to add your charisma to your ability to block.
I think so, but again,
so there is
I need charisma.
There is at least one kind of better light armor than what you've got. Also, there is the idea of what is your AC? Because it should be higher than what it is if your stats are...
It's 14.
No, it's not.
Then...
Hang on. What is your natural armor?
Because
that sets it at 13, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's 13 plus 4. Your AC is 17.
It's my AC.
Oh my bloody...
Have you been screwing yourself over all this time?
Yep.
Oh.
I need to mute myself for a second. Please excuse me.
I have fixed your stats, fair warning. Sometimes it has been changing for Haley, so it might change for you too.
Yeah. It keeps trying to knock me back down to 11 every time.
I return.
Okay.
Yeah, so
welcome
just
back.
Be warned, it'll try to knock you back down. Because I keep getting knocked back down to 11, it just automatically corrects. Because
it doesn't have a way to track what armor you're currently wearing.
Exactly. So it just goes 11, and I'm like, no, I'm 17, thank you very much.
Got it.
Yes, how was your swearing, Chewie asks.
It involved the word fuck multiple times in many creative, angry ways.
In a very short amount of time, so that's quite impressive.
You'd be surprised.
So yes, you all would like to make camp about, like, a mile away from this place?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
So, I think that makes most of the hits I've taken this entire day.
Not
I
hits.
Shouldn't have taken them.
Yeah.
Cool.
It also means you don't actually need to be wearing armor because your natural armor is automatically better than most potential light armor. Because the highest non-magical armor is 12.
Cool.
Yeah. So, as you start to... Basically, by the time that you reach where you left the wargs, you can feel that the curse has largely diminished. And then as it's diminishing, it really does feel like it was just cast to spite you. Just as punishment for doing something that you should not have done.
You apparently climbing that tree.
Yeah. You interacted with their property, and they took payment out of you in amusement.
I would like to point out that no one else was doing anything, but...
Well, also, none of us are sneaky sneakies.
Mm-hmm. Yes, so I literally did my job as a sneaky sneaky.
You just paid for that, and then I went and beat the crap out of the things for you, theoretically.
Yeah.
I shouldn't have actually
taken the damage that I did, yeah. So...
I was murder machine, so...
Yeah.
So, how exactly are y'all gonna set up camp, and are... Like, what is your plan?
We should probably do a watch rotation.
Yeah. I agree on that one.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think at least one of you should have an explorer's vouch, right?
I have...
Yeah, you've got an explorer's pack.
I've got a dungeoneer pack.
Okay. I don't remember the dungeoneer pack, but I know at least the explorer's pack has stuff to basically erect a really lazy tent. Mm-hmm. And all of them have bedrolls and stuff.
Okay.
But so yeah, so what is your watch rotation?
8, so let's see, 8 hours, there are 4 of us, we each take a 2-hour watch.
Yep, that works for me.
And we all have night vision now?
Yep,
yes,
I've got my night vision goggles.
Night vision, because you have night vision goggles, yes. And everyone else has dark vision.
I've got cool night vision goggles.
Sorry, no one actually has a tent, but all of you have bedrolls.
Which is fine.
Okay.
Yeah, that works.
So maybe we should go shelter outside of the menacing trees?
Well, where would outside of the menacing trees be, do you think?
I guess...
I don't know, we'd be going past the place that we battled the mini-groots, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much you left the wargs a little bit past there, and you've already moved past that.
Oh, that's right.
Your options are pretty much in the forest or pretty much in the swamp. Yeah, the night vision goggles are actually Chewie's fault.
Thank you, Chewie. I appreciate the night vision goggles.
I had him pick a number for what magic item Jiki had made, and he picked the goggles of dark vision or something like that. I don't remember what they were actually called, but...
Oh, perfect. That works, because I don't have dark vision, and everyone else does. Yay!
I will point out, you missed out on literally a bag of holding because of that, though. Yeah.
I mean, it's 601 right now because she needs dark vision.
But you can use a bag of holding to carry anything.
I don't know.
Yes. I'm aware of it.
It's literally a pocket dimension that you could put 500 pounds of something in.
We'll be grateful for what she got.
Yeah.
I am, because I don't have nightmares.
So where are you planning to set up this camp? Like I said,
do we want to do it in the forest or the swamp?
That's like to do like the edge of the forest, where we're not quite in the middle of the forest, but we're not in the middle of the swamp either.
They pretty much blend together.
Over. I'd say more forest than swamp, since all we have.
Yeah.
See? Squeam understands.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's just called a portable hole. A bag of holding isn't ideal if you can't see it. You might step in it and fall forever.
Like the bottomless pit.
I mean, in one of the campaigns that I think Miriam and I were both in, we had someone who was trying to buy an axe and ended up getting convinced to buy an axe, of smuggling, so it just had like a smuggling compartment. So we would put the bag of holding. Put a bag of holding in that so we could smuggle anything.
Aw, gotta love. Didn't we stick a goblin in there one time?
Briefly, however, there's only 10 minutes of air inside a bag of holding.
Alex put it in there!
Yeah.
Because his character does that sort of thing.
Yeah, the issue being that if the goblin, say, found a weapon and punctured it, the bag of holding would turn into just a bag. Because the pocket dimension would get punctured and everything would get sucked out back to wherever. Or back to another plane of existence.
Yeah. That might not have been the best idea.
Yeah. So your choices
That's
are basically...
why you don't put a...
Your choices for sleeping, basically, are forest, swamp, or point kind of in between where you'll have both.
Let's do the forest, then.
Yeah. Okay. I think forest would be better.
Okay.
I'll take the first watch, then, I guess.
Give me a survival check, Moira.
Okay.
Well, I'm assuming that you, as the only person with, I think, the survival skill, are the person looking for a good camping ground.
This is true. Still didn't do that great.
Not great, no, but you are able to find a pretty simple campground.
Running water nearby, bushes for a latrine.
Yep.
That works.
Pretty much. You found a relatively clean river by the standards of everything else you've seen here. And the trees aren't encroaching too heavily or terrifyingly. So, probably the best that you're going to be able to do.
Okay.
So. Yeah, I got a lot of those bush latrines. Okay, so, sorry, what is your watch order going to be?
I guess I'll take first watch.
I'll go next, I guess.
Jiki raises their hand. So is Nadar going to take the last one?
Nadar? Yeah, I'll take the last one.
Okay.
I put on my night vision goggles.
I didn't realize you took them off at some point.
No, they're sitting on the top of my forehead. I just lowered them.
Okay.
Because I figure, like, it's dusk.
Okay. Well, I think we're going to end off there because we have been going for 3 hours.
Which is less than our last stream.
Well, the last one was 5 hours.
Mm-hmm. That one was, like...
Oh, it took forever.
Yeah.
That was beyond.
Well,
so many monsters.
At least this time, it means that I don't have to do as much prep for next time. Because y'all didn't do it, get through everything I prepped, which is nice.
True.
Hey, all, thank you very much for finishing that video. If you liked what you saw, please remember to like, comment, subscribe, you know, that thing that every YouTuber says. Also, please check out our 365-day streaming challenge. We are streaming every single day of the week at twitch.tv/Nian, that's N-I-I-A-N 713. If you really like what we can do, you can also help support us on Patreon, that's patreon.com/layerofLore. We're on Facebook, Twitter, pretty much everything is Layer of Lore. You can even find us at layerofLore.com. layerofLore.com/streams will even have our full streaming schedule. And if you really just want to get in contact with us, yell at us about something good or bad, you can do that at masterminds@layerofLore.com. Thank you all very much, and we'll see you next time.